we're going to talk about bicycles, which may sound a little bit weird, but the reason I want to talk about bikes is that I was recently in a meeting for a group called EO, Entrepreneur Organization, or it's basically a group of entrepreneurs who get together every month and we discuss business topics and problems. And one of the EO Forum, which is the group members, just bought a bike company. And I was really, really impressed with what I saw at the factory. I'm not here to promote the bike or promote a bike, but to promote the idea of what the bike stood for, which is what I stand for. The company's called Griffin Bikes, and I thought I was really, really impressed with a couple things. One is that they use this proprietary material called boron carbide that has to be extruded through a metal to actually be able to make this bike frame. Now, that's extremely tedious, where you can only make a few bikes a month. You can't go on there and manufacture thousands like you could press something using titanium or aluminum. And the benefit of boron carbide is that it's a fraction of the weight. It's like half of what titanium is and about a third of what aluminum weight is. And it doesn't shear, so over time actually the material gets stronger and more gets denser over a period of years. And the other thing that was so impressive is looking at what's called a straight table. What this is a very heavy metal table, and they go in there and they measure the alignment of the front portion, I don't know what it's called, but near the handlebars to the seat and then down to where the wheels insert. And they check this multiple times. Most places, they don't care if the bike is dead on straight or true. All they do is just, you know, mass produce these bikes, and this will affect the ride. They only make 10 to 20 bikes a month. And Tony, who's the one that started this company, was very passionate about what he does. He only makes road bikes. Very specialized, very customized. And you go in there and you actually get fit for the bike. So it's actually customized for you. You actually go and they put all these pieces together. And you sit on the bike and you try it out, make sure it fits you. Then they actually begin the welding process and manufacturing process. And then they go back and retest over and over and over again in terms of making sure everything is straight and alignment before they actually put the paint on. Now, why am I talking about bikes? That's really a couple things that really represent what my company is all about and what I'm all about. Number one is passion. Passion for excellence, dedication for as much perfection as I can get out of it within reason, but obviously really focus on delivering excellent care. And, you know, I only do 1 to 2 surgeries each day, and I do it almost every day. So part of my philosophy is, you know, if you think about how most surgeons operate, they'll put 5 or 10 surgeries in one day. The question for you is, would you like to be their last patient of the day? Would you like to be number 9 or 10? I certainly would not like to be that last person, because I know that I'm tired by the time 5 o'clock comes around. I don't want to be operating on someone. So when you pay good money with me, the thing that I also offer you is the same thing that Tony offers you with Griffin, is passion about what he does and really looks at it as a craft of making the best product he can. In addition to that, really dedicating the time that's necessary to do a customized job for you, to spend time with you during the consultation and spend time with you during the procedure so that I can get you the best care, and also really to take that time afterwards to make sure that you're satisfied with what I can deliver for you over the long haul. So anyways, again, sort of a weird vlog, if you will, about bikes. It may not sound like, you know, why is this plastic surgeon talking about bikes? But I just wanted to give you a story about a company that I thought was really quite incredible in that regard. And why don't you hear about it? Well, the simple reason is that they don't believe in sponsorships, because they're not here to pay an athlete to go out there and, you know, ride their bike for them. And most bicyclists out there want, you know, money to be sponsored. And they're all about a great bike, and it's the same philosophy, same passion that I deliver when I do cosmetic plastic surgery of the face and hair restoration. Thank you.